Welcome to ATCM, the Emergency Medicine Channel. Today we are discussing about an important clinical topic, lab investigation, that is complete blood count. We will see what all things comes in complete blood count, and we will interpret each one, especially in emergency room, how to interpret complete blood count, we will see. Blood cells are otherwise called as hematopoietic cells. There are different types of blood cells. One is red blood cells, white blood cells and platelets. Red blood cells are otherwise called as hemoglobin or RBCs. They carry oxygen from lungs to various part of the body and supplies oxygen to that area. WBCs or white blood cells, they try to prevent infection. They help to resist against an infection in our body. Platelets, they produce platelet plugs and prevent bleeding from our body. So all these things are together called as hematopoietic cells or hemocytes or hematocytes. Around 40 to 45% of the blood tissue volume is these blood cells, and remaining 55 to 60% of volume is plasma. So blood contains blood cells and plasma. The volume percentage of blood cells in the blood, that is hematocrit, is measured by centrifuge or flow cytometry, and is 45% of the cells of total volume in males and 40% in females. So you can see here picture, there are different types of blood cells. You can see RBCs or erythrocytes. In WBC you can see basophils, eosinophils, neutrophils, lymphocytes, monocytes. Again in platelets also can be seen in this. Basophils, eosinophils, neutrophils together called as granulocytes. Lymphocytes and monocytes together called as agranulocytes. Totally all these things together called as leukocytes or white blood cells. Now we will see what is anemia. Anemia is a condition where the RBCs are low and the number of RBC or hemoglobin is low. The oxygen carrying capacity can be reduced when there is anemia. So anemia definitions are for different ages, it is different. Hemoglobin less than 13 gram per deciliter in men more than 15 years old. Hemoglobin less than 12 gram per deciliter in non-pregnant women more than 15 years old or adolescents aged 12 to 14. Hemoglobin less than 11.5 gram per deciliter in children aged 5 to 11 years. Hemoglobin less than 11 gram per deciliter in children aged 6 to 59 months. So this is the definition of anemia given by WHO. Whatever it is, when the patient is having anemic, the oxygen carrying capacity is reduced. So patients who is having anemia can have some symptoms of because of anemia, but all these symptoms can be aggravated if there is lung or heart disease. So the anemia definition is, even if the anemia definition is like this, patients who is having heart disease or lung disease, even on a higher percentage of hemoglobin itself, they can have symptoms. We can see now the common causes of anemia. One of the commonest causes for anemia is blood loss. Whether it is acute blood loss or chronic blood loss, blood loss is a major cause for anemia. Then bone marrow failure, bone marrow infiltration by various diseases, B12, folic acid deficiency, chronic illness induced bone marrow suppression, chronic blood loss, hemolysis, renal failure, where erythropoietin is produced. Erythropoietin deficiency can lead to anemia. Folic acid deficiency, chronic GI bleed, worm infestation, hypothyroidism, iron deficiency, all these conditions can lead to anemia. So when we get an anemia case, we should actually take detailed history to know what is the mechanism behind anemia, and lab investigation may tell you what are the probable mechanism for anemia. So here you can see different types of size of cell, size and color of cell. We can morphologically categorize this anemia. So microcytic anemia, normocytic anemia, macrocytic anemia. Microcytic means small cells, normocytic means normal cells, macrocytic means larger cells. That all depends on what is the MCV of this blood picture. MCV less than 80 is microcytic, normal MCV is 80 to 100. When the MCV is more than 100, we can call it as macrocytic. So when we have patients who is having anemia, normally we classify them into microcytic hypochromic, normocytic normochromic, macrocytic anemia. Hypochromic means the color of the blood cells are reduced. That normally occurs in iron deficiency anemia. So microcytic hypochromia means the size is reduced, the color is reduced. Both are classical features of iron deficiency anemia. So if you have a microcytic hypochromic anemia, MCV, MCH, MCHC all are decreased. So the size of the cell is reduced, color of the cell is reduced. Commonest cause for that is iron deficiency anemia. Other causes are thalassemia, sideroblastic anemia, chronic disease induced anemia, lead poisoning. Now you can see normocytic normochromic anemia. That means the size of the cell is normal, color of the cell is normal, still the patient is having anemia. So conditions are hemolytic anemia, acute blood loss. Immediately after blood loss you can have same picture, blood picture, but after sometimes it will become microcytic because of the iron deficiency. Bone marrow failure by chemotherapy or cancer infiltrates, renal disease, all can produce normocytic normochromic anemia. Macrocytic anemia means the MCV, MCH is increased, MCHC is normal. Vitamin B12 deficiency and folic acid deficiency is one of the major conditions which can produce large cells anemia. Okay. So that is because the immature cells are coming to peripheral circulation. Immature cells are actually larger. So MCV is larger. They are prone for hemolysis. Other conditions are aplastic anemia, non-megaloblastic anemia due to alcohol use, liver diseases, myelodysplasia. All these things can have macrocytic anemia. So basically anemia is differentiated into microcytic hypochromic, normocytic normochromic and macrocytosis. So whenever we have low hemoglobin in some patients, if you are seeing HB is low, immediately we have to look for the MCV, MCH, MCHC in these patients. So you can get a probable diagnosis from this itself. So that is very useful. Remember, normocytic means MCV is 80 to 100. Microcytic means MCV less than 80. If MCV is more than 100, we should suspect macrocytic anemia. In a patient, for example, in a patient who is having chronic blood loss from the intestine, like black stools are there. If we see the patient and the patient is having clinical findings of anemia, HP may be low, 8 or 10. If you see the MCV, it is low. That means most probably he is having iron deficiency anemia. Or somebody is not taking non-vegetarian diet, chronic vegetarian diet. This patient can have B12 deficiency. So if you check the patient's blood, there may be anemia. And most probably this will have MCV more than 100. So we have to make a diagnosis of B12 deficiency. So these are the simple ways to diagnose anemia in emergency room. These MCV, MCH, MCHC or RDW, that is red cell distribution width, all are called as red blood cell indices. So whenever we take a complete blood count picture in a computer printout, you can see all these things. So they have got importance only when there is anemia. So if there is anemia, MCV, MCH, MCHC and RDW, all these things are important. Otherwise, they are not that important in clinical practice, but whenever the patient is having anemia, you have to look all these things, MCV, MCH, MCHC. MCV is mean corpuscular volume. It's a volume of the patient's RBCs. It can be measured or calculated. MCH is mean corpuscular hemoglobin. It's an average hemoglobin content in an RBC. MCHC is mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration, is an average hemoglobin concentration per RBC. RDW is red cell distribution width. So all these things are important when you are managing a case of anemia. So complete blood picture contains all these values. So they have got importance when you are managing different types of anemia. Now we'll see the different types of anemia according to their morphologies. We have learned little bit in the earlier slides. Now we can see normocytic means normal size. MCV is 80 to 100. MCHC is 34 plus or minus 2. The causes are chronic renal failure, acute blood loss, hemolysis, anemia of chronic illness. You can remember the mnemonic CAHA. Microcytic means MCV is low. Commonest cause, we know that it's iron deficiency anemia. But remember the mnemonic TALES: thalassemia, anemia of chronic illness, iron deficiency anemia, lead poisoning, sideroblastic anemia. And that most important is iron deficiency anemia, including chronic blood loss from the intestine due to worm infestation or malignancies or ulcers in the intestine. Macrocytic means high MCV, MCV more than 100. Remember MALT. Megaloblastic anemia, which is the most important cause, B12 deficiency or folic acid deficiency, nutritional deficiency, because of mainly because of the diet which is not having B12 or folic acid. Alcohol, chronic alcoholism, chronic liver disease, thyroid disease, especially hypothyroidism. So these are the condition you should remember when you are planning to treat anemia cases. Now next important thing is thrombocytopenia. We know that normal platelet count in our body is 150,000 to 450,000 platelets per microliter of blood. So when it is reduced, we can call it as thrombocytopenia. But a clinically important thrombocytopenia is not less than 150,000. Clinically important is always less than 1 lakh. So you can see mild, moderate, severe thrombocytopenia. Mild is 1 lakh to 150,000. Moderate is 50,000 to 1 lakh or 99,000. Severe is less than 50,000. The action of platelet is it stops bleeding by clumping and forming plaques in the blood vessel injuries. If the patient develops thrombocytopenia, patient can develop purpuric rashes all over the body in the early phases. Then they can have bleeding from gums, bleeding from mouth, bleeding from nose, and ultimately it may lead to bleeding from everywhere, and patient can have bleeding including in the vital areas like brain or kidneys everywhere. So thrombocytopenia can lead to severe bleeding in some conditions like ITP and all, chronic ITP, idiopathic thrombocytopenia. Patient can have chronic thrombocytopenia, suddenly it can aggravate, patient can bleed. But remember, the counts are important. 150,000 to 450,000 is normal. If it is less than 1 lakh, it is clinically important thrombocytopenia, it is called as mild. If it is less than 1 lakh to 50,000, it is moderate. If it is severe, means it should be less than 50,000. We can see the cause of thrombocytopenia. Remember, platelets. Platelet disorders like disseminated intravascular coagulation, thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura, idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura, and various infection also can produce this type of conditions. Leukemia. Antibodies mediated diseases like SLE, trauma secondary to bleeding and DIC, enlarged spleen can destroy platelets, chronic liver disease with portal hypertension can again destroy platelets, alcohol or ethanol, drugs like heparin, aspirin, chemotherapy drugs, benzene, and sepsis. Remember platelets, the mnemonic platelets for thrombocytopenia. So you can see here picture, patient is having purpuric rashes all over the body. So that is due to bleeding in the subcutaneous plane. This is called as purpura. And normal platelet number you can see here, low platelet number you can see here. When the platelet number is low, there will be bleeding. Bleeding will not be arrested. But immediately after bleeding, sometimes blood can arrest the bleed in a different mechanism. We are not explaining that now. but platelet produces initial plaque formation in the acute bleeding area. So patient can have small bleeds all over the body. This is called as purpura. Now we can see different problems or problems in the leukocyte count. When we are interpreting the leukocyte count, we will get report like this: total leukocytes or total WBC count, that is 4000 to 11000 square millimeter. Differential counts can be neutrophil 2000 to 7500 cubic millimeter, lymphocytes 1500 to 400 cubic millimeter, monocytes 200 to 800, eosinophils 40 to 400, basophils 10 to 100. So these are differential counts. So neutrophils, lymphocytes, monocytes, basophils or eosinophils all come under total counts. You can see the picture here. Neutrophils are there, monocytes are there, lymphocytes are there, eosinophils are there, basophils are there. So the counts are very important. Whenever you have a infection or inflammation in any patient, normally counts will elevate. If it is a bacterial infection, neutrophil counts are increasing. Mostly if it is a viral infection, lymphocytes can be elevated, sometimes neutrophils can reduce. Now we can see the abnormalities in neutrophil counts. Neutrophilia means increased WBC count. Neutropenia means low WBC count. The conditions which can produce neutrophilia or increased WBC count, or the WBC count more than 11,000, they are common conditions are inflammations, infections, mainly bacterial or fungal. Typhoid is a bacterial infection, but neutrophilia is not a feature of typhoid. Infarctions like myocardial infarction, pulmonary infarction, malignancy like tumors, lymphoma, myeloproliferative diseases like leukemia, polycythemia. Leukemia, the counts will be very high, more than 50,000 you can see, total blood count can be 50,000. Another condition is leukemoid reaction. Leukemoid reaction means the blood counts are elevated, but there is no malignant cells. They are related to some inflammations. Sometimes inflammation can induce bone marrow overproduction. The count can elevate very fast, and it may be resembling leukemia. This is called as leukemoid reaction. Physiological, during pregnancy also we can have increased blood count. Neutropenia means low blood count, low WBC count. It's mainly occurring viral infection, bacterial infection like typhoid, brucellosis, rickettsia, TB, sometimes bone marrow infiltration can occur, severe sepsis, and most of the viral infections can have some amount of low WBC count or neutropenia. Severe neutropenia is not explained in all viral fevers. Very rarely viral fever can produce severe neutropenia. Bone marrow infiltration, malignancy, TB, sarcoidosis all can have. Alcohol can have neutropenia. Connective tissue disorders like SLE, RA and all can have neutropenia. Drugs like penicillamine, naproxen, chloroquine, methotrexate is very important. If we are giving methotrexate in higher doses, or folic acid is not given with methotrexate, patient can have neutropenia. Carbamazole, propylthiouracil, phenytoin, sodium valproate, carbamazepine, amitriptyline, captopril, enalapril, they are not very common, but rarely it can produce. Nifedipine, penicillin, cephalosporins, sulfadoxin, pyrimethamine, dapsone, sudafedrin. That most important drugs we should know is methotrexate, carbamazole, propylthiouracil, phenytoin, sodium valproate. Whenever we are treating patients with these drugs, always remember to check the WBC count. Neutropenia can produce a problem in this type of patients. Now, neutropenia is further classified into according to their severity, according to the numbers. Normally, absolute neutrophil count is more than 1500 cubic millimeter. It's normal, 1000 to 1500 or 1500 to 1000. that is a better way of explaining, it's coming down 1500 to 1000, less chances of infection, 1000 to 500 possibility of infection, less than 500 high chance of infection. Endogenous microbial flora, especially in the mouth, can also cause infection. They can produce opportunistic infection. Few clinical signs of infection can present, because when the counts are very low, the signs of infection or the inflammatory signs are very, very low. So you can get ulcers, but they don't have any inflammation surrounding that. Non-inflammatory oral ulcers, but they are painful. You may not see the pus in that this one, or inflammatory signs are not there. So that is a classical feature of neutropenic ulcers. So we have to treat the patient with antibiotic if we are suspecting infection, antibiotic or antifungal treatment. Less than 200 absolute neutrophil count, the inflammatory process is completely absent. You can calculate the absolute neutrophil count with this formula. Now, another important thing is in complete blood count is many patients you can see eosinophilia. You remember the mnemonic allergics. Allergic is allergy, Addison disease, lymphoma, L-tryptophan, eczema, respiratory diseases, gastroenteritis, infestations like parasitic or fungal, collagen vascular diseases. So these are the causes for eosinophilia. Normally in a complete blood count you can see 7%, less than 7% is what we see routinely. If it is more than 7%, if the patient is having any of these features only, we should investigate. Otherwise, some patients can have more than 7, 8 or 9. But if they have symptoms, mostly we have to think about this condition. And that most important condition is allergy only. So remember the mnemonic allergics. Other abnormalities like basophilia, monocytosis, lymphopenia, all these things you can see. Basophilia is seen in myeloproliferative disease, inflammatory bowel disease, iron deficiency anemia, monocytosis, TB, malignancy, inflammatory bowel disease. Lymphocytosis mainly you can see in the viral infection. And lymphopenia is one important feature that you should get in, you can get in many conditions like SLE, HIV, lymphoma, sarcoidosis, renal failure. That remember SLE, one of the classical presentation of occult SLE may be lymphopenia. So we may have to investigate this type of cases. Now we have discussed about different types of abnormalities in complete blood count. We have given an overall picture. We are not given complete picture of each condition. It's an overall picture of complete blood count. Thank you.